Girl, my boo Jesse, he's speaking out, honey. Yes, I told you guys, Jesse is speaking out, and girl, I got the receipts. Yes, I have everything he said, and guess what Jesse said? Oh, he put up a fight. He said, no, he ain't standing back like no damn coward. He said he fought back, and it's important to fight back, okay? Girl, ain't that something? All right, so make sure y'all like, share, subscribe to the YouTube channel, Gossip Girl XOX. You know you love me. All right, so you guys ready to see these receipts? All right, as you guys, I'm rocking the red hair, honey. You know, I'm feeling oh so yummy. All right, so let's play it because I'm ready to hear this. All right, Jesse, tell them what you got to say, boo.
I was bruised, but my ribs were not cracked. They were not broken. I went to the doctor immediately. Frank Gadsden drove me. I was not hospitalized. Both my doctors in LA and Chicago cleared me to perform, but said to take care, obviously. And above all, I fought the fuck back.
All right, well, y'all heard it. He said he fought back and he's great and he's a survivor, honey. What y'all got to say about that? I believed you, Jesse, okay? I always had your back, Jesse, okay? So let me tell y'all, this was a whole big scandal for y'all that did not know what was going on. Okay, so basically, I'm going to tell y'all Jesse's story first, all right? And then I was going to tell y'all what I heard, okay? Because that's what been pissing Jesse off and his whole family been speaking out because they're tired of people painting Jesse like the bad person when we got homophobic people out here, okay? We got racist people out here, the Trump administration people that's doing real harm to our people and getting away with it time and time again. And Jesse is a damn victim in this situation. And it's so damn sad that we have people out here that's making up stories. They're trying to bring Jesse down. He's the victim in all this, you know? That man, they done tied a rope around his neck. They done put bleach on his face. And they beat him up in the cold. When he was just trying to go get some sub, he was hungry. You know what I'm saying? He don't deserve this. So basically, let me tell y'all what's going on, okay? Now, these are true facts, what I'm about to spit to you guys. So y'all want to chill back and relax and listen up. They knew they wanted to get Jesse. Now, why do they want Jesse? See, that's the question that's just been filling my mind all day. Like, Jesse, what did you do? Why did the peoples want you? You know? I don't know. But anywho, they said, okay, you know Jesse work at Fox. He does this show called Empire with Lee Daniels and them. So he got letters sent to him at Fox talking about some, oh yeah, Jesse Smollett, he's a F-bomb. And you know what that F-bomb is, Sonny, that F-A. You know what I'm saying? I don't say that shit, you know. Yeah. But anyway, they was calling him F-bombs. They were saying they're going to plan on hurting him. You know, this was like a week before this situation happened. And Fox told him, they said, Jesse, you need to be cautious. You need to have some security with you. I got you, Jesse. But Jesse said no. Jesse said no. Jesse, what you smoking? He said no because it's invading his privacy. And I guess he wants to, I don't know, he want to feel free. So I said, you know what? That's fine. You know, because, you know, I'm trying to always be a writer. You know what I'm saying? I was like, that's fine. You know why? Because, I mean, Jesse just got God on his side. You know, he don't need no securities when you got the main security securing your future. Amen? Hello? You know, Jesse ain't say that, but, you know, I don't know. Maybe I don't even know if he believe in God. You know, religion is so, I just don't, you know what? Anywho, so I hope Jesse carrying like a weapon or a gun or something. Jesse, you carrying something? You should have got him with this pepper spray. At least if you catch somebody with the pepper spray, take a picture of him, Jesse, so we know and you know who the peoples is. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, Jesse's story is it was cold, he was hungry, and he went out at 2 to 3 o'clock in the morning, okay? Mind you, that's when the club's closed. But anyway, he went out 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning because he wanted to get him some Subway. You know, he wanted a 12-inch. He wanted that foot long, nigga. Y'all, what y'all know about that 12-inch, all right? He wanted a 12-inch. So he went to get his sub. You know what I wonder? And Jesse, I'm still on your side, okay? I'm just playing devil's advocate. I just want to know, did we see Jesse's Subway receipt? Did he make it to Subway? What type of sub did you get, Jesse? Did he not make it to Subway? Was he on his way to Subway? Or he had the sub and he was... Did they fuck the sandwich up? You know what I'm saying? We should have put the goddamn Subway receipt with the timestamp. You know, but anyway, you shouldn't have to do that, Jesse. Like I said, I'm on your side, okay? But Jesse done got his ass a 12-inch. And he's walking back home because he gonna eat. You know what I'm saying? And it's cold. You know, he's trying to, maybe he liked the cold sandwich. Who knows? Anywho, they said it was two men. He said, Jesse, this is Jesse's story. It was two men on a bench. You know, they was peeping Jesse out. They was looking at him strange, girl. Then all of a sudden, they was like, Jesse! They said, Jess. They said, ain't you that N that's on Empire? You that effing, you know, F, you know what I'm saying? You that fucking, you know, F word. That's what they called him, right? So Jesse looked back. He like, oh shit, hold on, look. You know, anyway, girl, he looked back and he like, who you talking to? I know you ain't talking to me, you know? Jesse wanted to let you know, like, listen, he stands up for here. So he started walking to him, you know what I'm saying? Because they got his attention. So they start standing up and they start facing each other, right? I guess they jumped him. You know, Jesse said they jumped him and they started putting bleach on his face and had the ropes around his neck, you know, and saying all homophobic and stuff, you know? And Jesse said it only took a minute and he left. And they have video footage of him entering his condo with the rope around his neck. You know what I'm saying? Now, what I heard is, and what people are saying, that Jesse is making all this up. Okay? He's doing it because of politics. He wants to get more involved in politics. So he had somebody fake send those letters to Fox. That's why he said he ain't want no damn security. You know what I'm saying? So a week later, they had planned to do this whole setup where he get the rope on his neck or whatever. This is what I heard, girl. Now, I don't believe it because I'm believing Jesse, you know? Oh, you listen, when you ride for your people, I don't care. Look, Jesse can be guilty as a motherfucker. I'd be like, Jesse, I'm riding with you, nigga. We got to learn how to stick together. I guess, you know, I don't know. But anyhow, y'all take what y'all want from it. So let me tell y'all the other stories, what we heard, okay? So another story we heard was Jesse has been messing with other people's boyfriend, okay? And he went to this gay club that night. It was very popular. And Jesse walked up in there like all sedity, like he all that, like he always do. And he seen the thought, okay? So the thought got a boyfriend, but this thought been cheating on this boyfriend with everybody, a whole bunch of people. So, you know, when he cheating with Jesse, he feeling like, you know, hey, he the shit, you know? And I guess the girl thoughts is just like the guy thoughts. The guy thoughts like the girl thoughts. Ain't they all thoughts? You know, they all want that attention. They all want that fame. They all want that celebrity. So he up in VIP hanging with Jesse while his boyfriend is out looking. You know what I'm saying? Where he at? You know what I'm saying? So he gets mad and he gets in this jealous rage And he tells his homeboy, he said, it's enough. He tired of Jesse taking advantage and, you know, I guess having his way with his boyfriend. And the boyfriend, I guess, the thought was trying to play it like, you know, Jesse, we're just friends. You know how Bill fuckers do. We just friends. You know, we just hanging out. It's not nothing like that, babe. But the boyfriend was like, oh, yeah. You know, in his mind, it is something like that. And I guess he ain't tell his boyfriend everything he knew. So basically, Jesse left the club because the club, they say, is in the area where Jesse has a condo. So he got a place right where he got the condo where the club is, so convenient. So he can just, you know, keep going as he please. So they followed him, you know, and they sit on a bench because they knew he was going home, right? So once he got to a certain area, that's when they start calling him names and they beat his butt. That's what I heard, okay? They said they beat his butt and Jesse was so upset over it that, and I guess shame, that he decided to call his PR team and his PR decided, let's, you know, revamp this story to make it the best that we can. I don't know. See, I don't believe all that. I feel like if the boys really wanted to beat up Jesse, why y'all ain't take a picture? You know, you want to take a picture, you want to take a video to let your boyfriend know, I'm the champ. I run this shit. You know what I'm saying? But they didn't do all that. And then Jesse only had a scratch on his eye. You know, they ain't do much damage. So I don't believe that. Then it was this other story that Jesse was on Grindr, which is a gay dating app, and he linked up with this guy, and this guy was like a serial beater-upper where he meet gay guys, but he pretend like he gay, but he really ain't gay. He a gay basher, and he be meeting the guys up. Come on, Mike! And that's what happened to Jesse. See, all these damn rumors about Jesse, it's just not right. And he's the damn victim of a hate crime. And that's horrible. We heard that same stuff with Jasmine. Jasmine came up and what did we do? We heard so many horror stories about Jasmine. Why do we always do this to these victims? You know, you're lying. You gotta be lying. Why they have to be lying? It's so many people that get molested, so many people got raped, there's so many people that get beat up and we don't hear about it. So when a person has the confidence and brave enough to speak out about it, we shame them. And that's why my hat goes off to people that speak out regardless. It's a damn shame. And that hurts even more when you have a whole grump of people talking about you lying and trying to make you off to be this awful liar person, which you're not. That's why I said, Jesse, I'm with you. And I'm glad you stood up and you stand strong for the fight, not just for you, but for everybody. So that's all I got to say. Make sure y'all like, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Gossip Girl, XOX. You know you love me.